further delay, we're going to start off with Dorothy Victor on the harp. I asked her a little while ago, how long have you been playing the harp? She said 74 years she's been playing the harp. But right now, let me introduce to you the great Dorothy Victor. Dorothy.
Shaped like half moons, and there were about 10, 15 strings on them, and they were sent along with the pharaoh when he died to the next world. But they also sent along the harpist. So it was very dangerous work. But now it's better. It's better. So it's safe for me to play. And royalty is still attracted to the harp. One of the royal people who played the harp was Queen Marie Antoinette, and her harps are in the Louvre Museum. And I'm going to play something she played. This was arranged by my teacher, Marcel Grandjean. Something for the Irish. something about the harp, and these harps are the American harps. Actually, the harp as it stands was invented in 1810 by a man in France named Sebastian Erard. And those harps, like this, had seven pedals around the base, three possibilities for each pedal. That means if you're a harpist, you don't go to a cocktail party before you're going to play. The strings are colored, so the C's are red and the F's are purple, so we know them apart. And so you cannot play in pitch black. When Mr. Erard invented his harp, he had a beautiful, beautiful sound. But soon, in 1890, our American harp was born. The Lyon and Healy harp, which are still made in Chicago to this day, and this is one of them. And the Erard harp, as a matter of fact, had quite a high neck. The strings on top of the harp were longer than the strings on the top of the upper register of this harp. But those Erard harps would break their necks pretty often. So with American know-how, we invented this harp, and it has short, short strings on top. It doesn't sound as good, but it works better. So now, harpist has a problem, and you've got to make a living. Well, there is one place you can always count on being able to play, and that's in a church. And I have played in every which church, every which place. And you're looking for a repertoire that will be acceptable in the greatest number of churches. And there is a piece that Bach wrote that seems to work in a lot of places. I'm going to play that for you, and you're going to recognize it.
Thank you.
best fun things is to play in concert. We, unfortunately, on the harp, do not have that wonderful repertoire that they have for violins and pianos and almost every other instrument. And I have just made my own arrangements of music I like, so that all the arrangements you're hearing are music I like and the way I play it. They're not written for harp. And that, it makes life interesting for me, because I'm always discovering something that I want to play, and then I can make an arrangement and play it. Now, so what would I play on a concert? I want to show you the kind of thing that I think it is very acceptable for that. And it is, I will soon find out. It is the Oriental of Enrique Granados. And Spanish music sounds wonderful on the harp, because it sounds so much like other instruments. So I'm going to play this one for you. Another a wonderful business for us is the funeral business. And here's the problem. You play at all different kinds of funerals, and you don't want to play music that doesn't apply to some religious group or some belief or some whatever. So it's good to find some classical music, I think, that's just a little bit sad, even though they don't need it for funerals, but that might be appropriate. And never go wrong like that. So I'm going to play the piece of Monsieur Albinoni, his music in G minor, and I think this is perfect for funerals. We'll see what
Thank you. real personal favorites. This is the first. I'm going to play you a classical piece that I just love. I made an arrangement of this last year, and I heard it on the music station. I had to play it. And it's called Recuerdos de la Alhambra, which I think means Memories of the Alhambra. And it's written by Tarega. And again, it's written for guitar. And all things written for guitar sound good on harp for some reason or other. So now I'm going to do my arrangement of this piece.
Song. for in exchange for a donation to the Theater Guild. I'd like to make a request of, as time goes by, I'll donate an additional $25 to the Theater Guild.
All right, now I think that I can explain to you, I don't know as time goes by. I play, and I have a record of doing this. When we were young and poor, and my husband and I were living on $15 a week for food and carfare, I was playing, and a man came over to me. He'd been drinking all right, and he said, "What Harbor Lights?" Uh-oh, Harbor Lights. Well, I seem to remember a little bit of the melody, and I started out, but I couldn't remember the middle part. And the man's there, and he handed me $25. And so I wasn't gonna give that money back, because he needed it. And so I played, well, I knew of Harbor Lights, I don't know, maybe 16 measures, and I played it in every key, and I played it backwards and upside down, and I fooled around with it for a good 10 minutes. And I figured he got his money's worth. I smiled at him, and that was it, and I'm keeping the money. And yeah, so, yes, I play as time goes by, but I don't know that either. Oh, bless
them. You played it earlier.
Well, but I just still don't know. He said, and here's what you kind of do. I know it goes like this.
$50.
You bet.
friend of mine is going to celebrate a very special birthday, so would you please play Happy Birthday?
Well, any key. Any key.
How much will you pay?
Would everybody like to hear from you?
Yeah!
It's the most sentimental song. Thank you.